The goal of this project is to capture the knowledge and experiences of change leaders to help inform other departments and colleges in transforming their STEM programs. We interviewed 8 individuals from institutions across the country. We asked them what the biggest challenges of recruiting a diversity of students was, and this is what they had to say.
It was hard to recruit the students that we wanted to see, those who didn't necessarily have experience. So we did targeted outreach and looked at schools that had high Pell Grant recipients, maybe were less funded or supported with affinity programs, and started inviting them and encouraging them to apply and reaching out to them whenever it was application period and stuff like that. And now, yeah, CS Ed Day looks entirely different. You know, it's probably at least 50% female, and then I don't know, but probably 25 to 33% students of color, whereas the major is like 3% now.
We started a program called the CS Ambassadors. And so this was a group typically of juniors and seniors in the department who would meet with prospective students every week, sometimes twice a week. So people could sign up for tours. They would come bring with their parents. They would get to meet current students. They usually got to have a little coffee with a faculty member. They got to visit a classroom. And so I think, you know, it helped them to see themselves as students. They got to get a lot of questions answered that you may not find on the website. So that, I think, has been a success in, you know, lots of students take tours at the university, but having them at the department level, especially at a really big university, gives you a better feel for what it's like to be in the department. I would say that the top 10% rule added to that challenge. So instead of recruiting very broadly across the state and at high schools, we ended up trying to recruit students that were admitted to UT. So if they were admitted to the department especially, those were the students that we really, you know, went after. We created something called the Dream Team. It was a group of girls who made phone calls, sent emails, invited the students to campus. They hosted a visit day. And so we felt like for the amount of time that we had to do recruiting, you know, recruiting students who were already admitted was where we needed to put our time.
We bring in 60 women at a time. Diverse Bites, and then we bring in 60, First Bites is women and non-binary, people who identify as non-binary, and Code Longhorn, our other one, which is now the Summer Academy for All, is more around diversity, around race, ethnicity, culture, we bring in 60 people at a time, and we found that to be about the right number. Like, we can sort of get to know each other, right? It's a good cohort. It took me a long time to understand that when I said women, all women didn't feel like they were included. And so that was some learning I had to do.
We also do a lot of recruitment once students are admitted to our program. So one big thing that we do is the Office of Admissions at UW has an admitted student preview day where students are invited to come on campus and actually kind of get a sense of what it's like to be here in our community. I think that's a huge way for students to really picture themselves here at the UW and the Allen School. So we do campus tours that day. We have a welcome from our director, we have a mock lecture, and then we also have students who are current students who are really helping us with recruitment. So we have our student ambassadors who are paid employees do tours of our buildings. They also just talk about their experiences, and we really encourage them to be genuine in their experiences. And so we don't provide any type of marketing sort of knowledge that they have to have. We truly want them to talk about what it's like to be a college student. And this work takes a lot of time, energy, and resources. So we put a lot of energy and resources and money into making sure that we are kind of continuing to make progress in our DEIA work. Some specific initiatives that we're really proud of that we've been working on. One, we have a program called the Changemakers in Computing program. It's a 4-week summer program that I started with students The program is intended for students who do not have computing knowledge, who are rising juniors and seniors in high school. They are with us for 4 weeks on campus, and it's actually a paid experience. So they get $2,500 to participate with us. And the goal is to really offset the missed wages that they would be getting if they were working over the summer. Our focus is on systemically marginalized students who typically do need to work while they're in the summer to support their families. And so we want to make sure that students have access to that experience without putting a financial burden on their family. The Changemakers in Computing program does teach some computing knowledge, just basic computing knowledge, but the core component of the program is really to think about what are the negative and positive aspects of computing and how can you be a change maker in the computing field.
We created an outreach plan and we contacted many of our students by phone. A group of my students, I organized it. We created scripts. And we actually talked to them and gave them any information they wanted about our college and who we are, and made sure to represent ourselves as who we are, because we don't want anyone to feel that, wait a minute, this is not what I thought. But it was amazing to be able to share some of the things that we have in the organizations and the people that we have. And if they had a question about even their classes, a lot of the students that were doing these calls were CS students and in other departments, so they could give them firsthand their experience in the community. It is a community that we have created for our students that are incoming students. And it includes really cool activities and experiences. And it also includes engagement with faculty and a lot of different opportunities. And the students that are going to be in the RAP, which is a living learning community, will be taking some specific classes with each other in those classes. And the classes that we are working to, the design of the program, it really gives a voice to marginalized voices in computing. And we are really going to focus on women in computing and other people from other racial identities in computing, and presenting the material and engagement, extracurricular engagement, with a lens that is wider rather than a narrow focused lens, which they may be receiving in other ways.
We're a lot more advanced now in terms of our own use of technology to communicate to these students. But you want to be careful, right? Because you don't want to then just keep dumping things on them to do that. So one of the things that I do now is we participate in, as the university goes on its basically nationwide tour of admitted students, they invite admitted students to various receptions around the country. And as the dean, I attended all of them and met with students, met with parents, met with students and parents that weren't identified as students in the Luddy School, but I wanted to talk to them anyways.
So we started a initiative where current faculty go try to talk to students in minority serving institutions. And so just last week, I know that one of our faculty members was at Spelman College and I think also Morehouse College in Atlanta. So we started that initiative. A couple of our faculty have started, one in particular, but I think it's two, started a summer reading research type program for PhD students at other institutions who are interested in their research. And they specifically reached out to students who have been historically minoritized in tech to encourage them to join those reading groups. We decided to implement Zoom calls with current women in computer science reaching out to the prospective women who were interested in computer science. So that group of accepted students, we reached out to them, invited them to a Zoom call, and I had a number of women from our ACMW group, for example, and other women that are role models within the department participate on those Zoom calls. And then the following year, we looked to see how we did, and the percent of enrolled women went up to 24%. If you can get them in the door and show them how impactful computing is and the number of jobs that are available in all sorts of fields, you know, you can combine computing to anything, whatever else you're passionate in, add it to computing, and they need people. So if you can just get them in the door, that's the biggest challenge. So at Mines, one of the things that we have done is we have slowly expanded the number of students who are required to take our first intro CS class. So initially, it was just the computer science students. Then it became, you know, computer science and math. Then it became computer science and mechanical engineers. And then it became, and we slowly expanded it. And now they are voting this year to make it required for all students. And I think that'll be, at least for Mines, that'll be a big win. But it'd be nice if all institutions, either at the high school level or the college level, doesn't matter, required a computing class. Because once you get them in the door, it many students are like, wow, actually, I thought I would hate this, but I love it. Yeah.